For if the dead are not raised, then neither has Christ been raised. The belief that the dead can rise from their dreamless slumbers to once again walk the land of the living, known more succinctly as resurrection, predates the most famous resurrection story of all time by certainly thousands of years, as do the debates about whether a resurrection is even possible. The ancient Greeks generally denied the concept of a physical resurrection, even though several characters from their mythologies, such as Asclepius, Achilles, Castor, Alcmene, Heracles, and Melicertes, were raised from the dead and deified or made immortal like the gods. According to the book of Acts, when Paul tries to convince a group of Greeks in Athens that Jesus had been raised from the dead, Paul gets the cold shoulder from most of them. Now, when they heard of the resurrection of the dead, some began to sneer, but others said, "We shall hear you again concerning this." It wasn't that they had anything against Jesus. Most had never heard of him, but the idea of coming back to life after the body had decomposed was simply a ridiculous proposition to them. I can almost hear them muttering, "Oh, great, the old decomposed corpse come to life claim again." Even among the Jews of Jesus' day, there were those who did not believe that the resurrection was even possible. Then the Sadducees, who say there is no resurrection, came to him with a question. The question the Sadducees posed to Jesus concerned the precise nature of the afterlife and how the personal relationships held during life would translate into the hereafter. For example, if a woman was married 7 times during her life, who would be her husband in the afterlife? Inquisitive bunch, those Sadducees. In the middle of the 3rd century CE, an early Christian apologist named Origen wrote a quite lengthy work called Contra Celsus, or Against Celsus, which was a direct response to a writing by Celsus called The True Word. Celsus was a staunch critic of Christianity and the general idea of resurrection as well. Ironically, his work is preserved only in the larger work that attacks it. What they say of a land which is better and more excellent than this has been borrowed from certain divine ancient writers, and chiefly from Plato. Their ridiculous teaching on the subject of the resurrection is derived from what they have heard on the doctrine from Plato, jumbled and misconstrued. They uphold this doctrine in order that they may see and know God. So, it seems I'm arriving a tad late to this debate, but I'd like to propose the idea that we can now present evidence that was simply not available to our ancient ancestors, by which we might conclude beyond a reasonable doubt not that the resurrection of Jesus most likely did occur, but that beyond a reasonable doubt, the resurrection of Jesus most likely never occurred.